So for today's lecture, we are going to start with the next topic, that is, what do you mean by threat agents? We have already seen few topics related to cloud security. Now we are going to move to the next topic, that is threat agents. First, we are going to look into what do you mean by it. So if I talk about threat agent, basically it can be referred as the main agents, or you can say the main areas, or main, you know, where the threats actually arises, you can say, or where your threats actually come into the picture. Okay, so agents are nothing but, you can say, a software application, that can be an extruder, that can be a person, that can be anyone, from where the threat is actually going to come or it is going to take place. Okay, so in case of cloud security, if I talk about threat agents, that can be either internal agent or that can be either external agent. If it is internal agent, then it is going to be software. If it is external agent, then that is definitely going to be a human. So agents are nothing but, you can say, place, or you can say a medium through which the threat, possibility of the threat arises, or where the attacks can be taken place. Okay, so it is always suggested that you should keep security mechanisms strong, and you have to keep checking the loopholes of your system, because the main reason or the main cause of entering into the system, or the area through which anybody can enter into a system, is through the weak holes or vulnerabilities or weak areas of your securities which are there into your system. Like, we have a cookies. Cookies is something which is a confidential information. So you need to always clear your cookie. So the threats usually look for these weak areas, and the very first point of contact to attack is those weak areas, and then enter into the system. Because they know that this is are only the areas through which you can, they can hack your system, or they can have an access to your system. Okay. So just, we can conclude that threat agents are nothing but, you can say, those agents that have a possibility to carry out the attack, or that has a possibility to attack over any system. So next, we are moving to the categories of attacker which are there. When we talk about threat agents, definitely they are going to be type of agents, right? So we are going to look into the very first type, that is anonymous attacker. Okay. So anonymous, the word itself means somebody whom you don't know is coming from outside. You have no, you know, idea about it. Who is he? From where he is he? From which network it does it belongs to? So that is called as anonymous attacker. So basically, these are the ones who are going to be non-trusted ones. Okay, and these are the types of the agents, or you can say attacker, who is always going to attack from your cloud boundaries, outside of your cloud boundaries. Like, whenever we talk about any cloud, okay, we have a boundary created. Okay, like, you cannot enter that boundary. Okay, so anybody who is anonymous, you don't know much about, like, how to enter that boundary, because some are there who know very well, so they can even, you know, bypass the boundary. But mostly those who are outside, who are don't know about the boundary, and they usually they do the attacks outside from that boundary, those are called as anonymous attacker. Okay, all the category of attacker definitely is going to be non-trusted ones, but there are, you know, some intruders also, like, who are working inside, and they are also knowing about the boundary, so they can even attack from inside. But somebody who is outside, who is anonymous, who doesn't belong to that particular network, or he doesn't know much about that, and if they want trying to attack from the outside of the boundary, that are usually referred as anonymous attacker. So the second category of agent is malicious service agent. Okay, so basically, when I talk about malicious, it simply refers that something is wrong, something is fishy, that is referred to as malicious, because we usually refer this word when we talk about with respect to any threats, we usually refer this word, that is malicious. Okay, so malicious, something you can, like, you can say something which is done deliberately, okay, with an intention to do it, that is called as malicious. So these are the type of the agents who are going to intercept, who are going to check for your network traffic. Okay, they are going to make sure that if there is no network traffic, so they'll make sure that there is a traffic within the cloud, so that whatever transfer is being taking place, they can have an access to that, and they can see the contents that which is transferred. Okay, so here, if you talk about malicious service agent, they can be existing as an external program who are remotely doing this, or they can be someone who are internally present there and who are monitoring the traffic, and they're doing it. Okay, they can even corrupt the message contents, they can delete the message contents, they can make the content missing as well. So these are the type of malicious service agent. So just remember in one thing, these are the type of the people who have deliberate intention that whatever your data is being transferred across the cloud, they are going to make sure that they are going to forward the traffic between it so that the transfer time will be more. And since the transfer time will be more, between that meantime, they can have the access to that particular data. They can sniff, they can spoof, okay, they can do it. So that can be your external program, which is controlled remotely. And that can be, you know, they can corrupt the message, they can do some changes to the message, or they can be internal program as well. Category, that is trusted attacker. Okay. So if you talk about trusted, again, your refers to that, here is the one who is going to be the trusted one. Again, attacker of any type is always belongs to untrusted only. Okay, but they have just given a different name to it, that is trusted attacker. So basically, this is attacker, you can say, somebody who is internal to the organization. Okay, like who is sharing the IT resources, he's sharing the, you know, same environment like your cloud consumer. Okay, and then he is attempting to steal the credentials just to target the cloud providers, and like he is going to have an unauthorized access. Okay, like even if I'm sharing my space, you can say, or even if I'm sharing my environment, I am the one who, you know, is not much to that doing attacks or something, but somebody with whom I'm sharing is more into this because he wants some credentials of the software, he wants something else. So this is usually termed as a trusted attacker who is belonging to the same cloud environment and who wants some credentials to have an access to the other services which is provided by the cloud providers. Then it is called as trusted attackers. So they are also called as malicious tenants, okay? Because they are going to, they know the internal environment of the cloud because they are sharing the same environment, they are sharing the same network. So they know many things, okay? So they will try to exploit, they are going to use some permutation and combinations, like they are going to check like how the authentication is, whether it is strong authentication, or whether it is weak authentication. Then it is going to try to break the encryption. It is going to try to send some spamming of the email accounts, or it will just simply do it DDoS attack, that is denial of service attack. So this is trusted attacker. The reason here is like he's the one who is either a cloud consumer who is sharing the same platform, and he's trying to have an access to the services of the cloud providers without knowing him. Okay, that is why it is called as trusted attacker. Like they, you want their other services, you don't want to pay for that services, but you want to hack that services and then you want to use it in other words. Okay, so that is why it is called as a trusted attacker, because he is the one who is insider. You know that person, he is your cloud consumer, he is sharing the same environment, but he is trying to have an access to the other piece of software or other piece of code without asking or without paying for that service. Next category of threat agent is malicious insider. Okay, so basically malicious insiders are, you know, they are the people who are working, you can say, inside here simply refers to they are working inside the environment of the cloud, and they are acting themselves as a cloud provider. Okay, and then they are having an access to the confidential information of the cloud consumers, or you can say cloud provider services or premises. Okay, so basically main intention of this type of threat agents is like they want to have an administrative privileges so that they can access consumer IT resources on behalf of them, and they can do anything what they want to. Okay, so basically these are the insiders people, those who are wanted to act themselves as a cloud provider, and they are wanted to use cloud consumer services, and they want to have the privileges, administrative privileges, for accessing all the services. So that is called as malicious insiders. So mostly they are the people, those who are within the environment, or you can say anybody who belongs to the cloud provider environment can be tried to do that. So that is your malicious insider. Next is the notation, like whenever you want to represent that there is a attack which is done by humans. Okay. So, or you can say the attack which is done from the workstation, then we usually use this type of symbol, which implies that there is the threat engine and that attack was done with the via workstation. So this is the notation of showing an attack. Next, we are moving to the next category of the threats, that is cloud security threats. We are done with the general threat agents category. We are moving to the next, which are usually threats which are usually done over the cloud security. Okay, so here you are going to look into different
vulnerabilities which usually takes place into your cloud environments. And we are going to see the roles of the threat agents as well here, that how they are acting there. So the very first type of attack here is traffic eavesdropping. Okay, so traffic eavesdropping basically occurs that whenever your data is being transferred from one cloud to another, or you can say from a cloud consumer to the cloud provider, basically here the malicious service agent is going to be here and is going to check for, you know, information which he's going to look for, which is being sent from the consumer to the cloud provider. So this information which is going to be sent is something that he doesn't have an access to that information. For him, it is an unauthorized access. But for the cloud consumer and the cloud provider, it is authorized access, because they are, you know, authorized people and they know that what information is being passed through the network. So here the malicious service agent is going to work here and he's going to look for all the information which is being sent, and it is going to be illegitimate information for him because he doesn't have an access to that information. So main attempt of this attack here is to compromise the confidentiality of the data, okay, to know how, what is the relationship between the cloud consumer and cloud provider, what information they are sending across the network, what sensitive information is being sent, what that information consists of, okay? Since this is a type of a passive nature of attack. Why it is passive nature? Because your cloud consumer and cloud provider are not going to be connected all the time, okay? Once the consumer sends the message, it will wait for the acknowledgement. It is not going to be active all the time for receiving the acknowledgement from the cloud provider, okay? So here, most of the time, you know, time may be more, the time may be less, depending on how the network is. Okay, so here, the one who is a malicious service agent, he is going to try to, you know, act as a middleware between the consumer and provider, and he will try to intercept the message, or you can say he will try to copy the message. Okay, want to read the contents. If he get an access to that message, then he will make some changes to the message. He can delete some contents, and then with that changes, the same will reach to the cloud service provider. Okay, so that is called as traffic eavesdropping. Basically, he's going to look for the message which is being transferred within the cloud, and he will try to intercept it. He will try to have an access to that message, and he will try to change that message. So basically, he's going to look for the sensitive information and going to change the details of the information. So this is the very first, that is traffic eavesdropping. Next category of cloud security attacker or agent is malicious intermediary. Okay, so basically this is the one who is going to, you know, not going to have an access to the messages, but it is also going to alter the message. In previous, he was just having an access to the message where he used to just copy the message. Okay, but here he is going to copy as well as he is going to do the alteration. Okay, so message confidentiality or integrity is going to be lost here, because he is going to insert some data, he is going to make some changes to that data before it forwards it to the destination, that is nothing but the cloud provider. So in the previous technique, which previous agent which was there, okay, here in traffic eavesdropping, you have to just need to remember, here he will just have the access to this message, okay, he is going to just copy the message, okay, but here he is going to copy the message as well as he is going to, you know, changes to the message, is going to delete some message and is going to change the content. Okay, and this is going to again done by your malicious service agent, the type of the agent which we have already studied before. So intermediary here simply refers to that he is going to act as an intermediator in between your cloud consumer and cloud provider. He is going to have an access to that messages. He'll try to intercept this message. He is going to alter that message. He is going to, you know, change the content. So the integrity lost in that case, you can say, and then this, with the changes, the same message will be sent to the cloud provider. Okay, so next we are moving to the type of the attack. You can say this is a DOS attack. Everybody must be knowing about this attack. So basically, this type of attack is what, you know, you're going to overload your network, the other one's network that can be the other one whose network you want to access. So you're going to just flood that particular network with lot of packets, and those packets are something which is not usable to anyone. So you're just going to simply flood with a lot of packets in the network to make sure that the person's or you can say the computer or the device whose services you want to hack, so that it cannot do its task, but it will be, you are going to just flood with the unwanted packets into that network. Okay, so basically it's the objectives of DOS attack is to overload your IT resources to that point that it will not function properly, because it will just keep sending you unwanted packets, and because of so many packets, whatever IT resources has to do the task, whatever they want to do the services, they won't be able to do that. Okay, so unnecessary flooding your network with the packets or unwanted services to stop your network to do what it is intended to do is called as DOS attack. Okay, so here the cloud services are going to be artificially increased. The same messages are going, requests are going to be repeatedly seen. Same messages are going to be copied again and again. So it is just, you know, flooding your network with unnecessary things and not letting the IT resources to do or to take the another request or fulfill the another request. Okay. So here your network is going to be overloaded with traffic. The responsiveness will be low here, and then the performance is definitely going to degrade or it is going to go down. Okay. So all the cloud requests already which are sent are going to be pending here, because most of the memory is being used by this, you know, unwanted flooding of services which is taking place, or request which is already done is going to come again and again. So because of that, whatever is your new service requests which are there, you are not going to be able to fulfill. So that is called as DOS attack. This is always done intentionally, always remember that. And the main reason to do this, so that your other network is unavailable, it is temporarily unavailable for that point of time, and it will not do that thing which it is designed or designated to do that. Okay, so that is your DOS attack. So for example, just I'll give you a small scenario wherein I don't want my cloud provider, me as a hacker, I don't want the cloud provider to provide the service. So what I will do, I will keep sending unwanted packets to the network of the cloud provider. So he will not be able to fulfill the next request which is given from the cloud consumer, because most of the memory is just, you know, utilized in this particular packets, unwanted packets, which he is getting randomly from other network. And because of that, there is a lot of traffic on his network and it's not able to fulfill any more requests. So there is a possibility that because of load, the particular network may go down for some point of time and it will not able to take any new request. So that is your denial of service, that is DOS attack. We also have another category, that is distributed DOS attack, where multiple networks or multiple computers are attacking over just one computer. Then this is called as distributed DOS attack. So this is mostly done in the networking just to make sure that your computer whom you want to attack is not able to do the thing which it wants to do. So you're just simply flooding that network with unwanted packets, message requests, and trying to overload the traffic so that the responsiveness is reduced. So that was your DOS attack. So that's it for the day. Next topic we are going to look into in the next lecture.